Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.1, Problem 13. This is problem number 13 from the homework from Section 1.1. It says, find the equation of the line that has an x-intercept of negative 6 and a y-intercept of negative 3. So ordinarily, when we have a problem where we have to find the equation of a line, we go to the formula y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, and we underline the values y1, m, and x1. We have to put in a number value for those, and we leave the rest of it the way it is, and we can simplify it at the end. Now, this question doesn't seem to fit the same format. The x-intercept of negative 6, where would that go? Well, what you have to realize for this is the problem saying the x-intercept of negative 6 is giving you a point with the coordinates negative 6, comma 0. The x-intercept is negative 6, means this line crosses the x-axis back 6. So if you go back 6 and up 0, it'd be right on the x-axis, it would cross at negative 6. So x-intercept of negative 6 means you have a point with the coordinates negative 6, 0. Now, similar reasoning, the y-intercept of negative 3 means that this line crosses the y-axis down 3. That's a different way of giving you the coordinates 0, comma, negative 3. Y-intercept of negative 3 means you're going through the point over 0 and down 3. So now that we have the coordinates of two points, now it's much more similar to some previous problems that we've done. The first point, the x-coordinate of negative 6, I can label the x-coordinate as x1 and the y-coordinate as y1. The negative 6 becomes x1, the 0 becomes y1. So the first point has an x value of x1 and a y value of y1. The y-intercept is given second, so I consider it to be point 2. Its x value will be x2, and its y value will be y2. So the value of x2, in terms of filling out my formula, is going to be 0, and the value of y2 will be negative 3. And again, pay attention to the negatives. Very easy to make a careless error with those. As I start filling it in, I'm going to need the value of m, which is slope. Now, the slope is not given in the problem, but we can figure it out. And what we would do is start with a formula for slope. M equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And we put the values that we had labeled into that formula. So as I start filling it in, y2, I have a value of y2 that is negative 3. Then minus y1. The value of y1 is 0 from the way we label the given information. In the denominator of the slope formula, I start with x2. X2 has a value of 0, again from the way we label the given information. Then minus x1. My value of x1 is negative 6. So again, 2 negatives, 0 minus a negative 6. One negative coming from the slope formula, the other negative coming from the coordinate of the point being negative. Now, as I simplify that, in the numerator, negative 3 minus 0 is minus 3. In the denominator, 0 minus a minus 6 is really 0 plus 6, which is positive 6. So negative 3 over positive 6, I can reduce to negative 1 half. So that's the slope, which I'm going to plug into my formula for the equation of a line. Now that I found the slope, I can go back to the formula y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1 and put the values in where they go. I start with y. It stays y. Then minus. Now y1 requires a number value. So when I go to y1, the way I labeled it, the value of y1 is 0. Then equals. Next piece I have to put in a value for is m for the slope. And we had figured out that the value of the slope of this line is negative 1 half. Again, don't forget the negative. Then I start my parentheses. I put in this x, this will stay my answer. Then minus, and now the value of x1 is negative 6. And I close my parentheses. Now, that is the answer for the equation of the line, but like a lot of the problems before, it's not really simplified as far as it should be. But it is the equation of the line. So to simplify it, again, most teachers like that you put it in the y equals mx plus b form, which means solve it for y. So to do that, on the left, the y minus 0 really is just y. We can just make that a y. And now, the negative 1 half times the parentheses, I can push the 1 half through the parentheses. Before I do that, let me leave negative 1 half out in front and make the x minus a minus 6 into an x plus 6. That'll help. And now I can multiply the negative 1 half in front of the parentheses times each piece that's inside the parentheses. So on the left, I just have y. And then, on the right, negative 1 half times x is negative 1 half x. And then negative 1 half times positive 6 will be minus 3. Again, pay attention to your signs. And now it's solved for y. It's in y equals mx plus b form. So the equation of the line that has an x-intercept of negative 6 and a y-intercept of negative 3 is y equals negative 1 half x minus 3.